绍一下与会的这个嘉宾，按照各位的顺序来跟大家做介绍。右手边第一位，这位就是各位的老师陈启山教授，他是台北科技大学的这个资深教授，在我们这个行业里面有非常深的这个资历，又是有化学博士。他在这个专利里面替我们的资材去做了很多的审查案件，而且他的服务远播到了国外去。等一下他会跟我们分享一下，至于这个好的专利怎么样去养成，到底台湾的企业应该怎么样来盈利。第二位呢是远从韩国来的沈东炫沈教授，三星就有大概20多年，那么是日本的授权部的总经理，然后后来在 Intellectual Discovery， 就是韩国的政府基金对抗Patent Troll， 大家应该知道说这个恶意诉讼这个部分，韩国最早面临这个问题，所以他是在这个公司担任执行的这个 Director。 目前呢他也在跟三星非常有关系的一个 SNKIP 里面担任他自己公司的这个董事长。今天会跟大家介绍一下标准必要的养成，大家知道你用的这个 MPEG HEVC 还有 D 啊这些很多的这个标准必要技术都是他实际参与授权到全球的。专业呢其实中国邀请他好多次到中国去做演讲，而且给了他很多的consultancy 跟这个 professorship。 现在坐在第三位的这位呢就是非常有名挑动这个三星跟苹果手机大战全球大战的这个要角，他曾经担任三星 display 三星电子的 VP 副总裁，是三星display general counsel， 前几年担任 intellectual discovery 的董事长。目前韩国政府又委托了他一个很重要的职务，就是在韩国的创新智慧财产平台由他来做这个主席，所以呢韩国有很多的经验，等一下他会跟我们做这个分享。还有一个很特别的，就是他其实是我见过学位最多的人，他有4个不同领域的硕士，还有一个 JD， 所以我们也可以跟他做一个很充分的学习。像昨天他也在我们学校做了很深刻的演讲，他会告诉你说三星到底是怎么样变成今天这样的一个起步。接下来是我们台湾的这个前辈，我们的我的老师的老师，我的师祖那个黄清源黄教授，他是这个藏在国际事务所的资深合伙人，他在我们那个公平交易法并购，还有全台湾几乎有一大半以上的这个大企业保险公司，全部他都是做他的 legal counsel， 还有我们的公平交易有很多的这个法案的建议，所以呢，等一下他跟我们分享很多很重要的这个案件。那另外呢，在黄教授下隔壁是我们很有名的万国法律事务所智慧财产部的这个主持律师，大家知道 Hello Kitty 吧？ Hello Kitty 怎么样在台湾维权、全球维权都是他们公司做的。怎么样让公司很有面子，然后让企业很有面子？那当然不只是这样，我们的智慧财产权法院的这个法规一样的推动，台湾很多重要的这个专利诉讼都是他们事务所所做的。大家知道说之前的那个智慧财产局的美花局长，是他们主持律师的夫人，然后他们的那个主持律师顾律师现在也是我们金管会的主委，所以在台湾的这个司法界，他们事务所担任了蛮重要的一个角色。在郭律师隔壁的是我们的前辈，我们企业跟学界的前辈，然后就是我们的郑中仁郑老师。那大家知道 TSMC、Acer 啊、明基，好多好多公司，他都是非常资深，很早很早前就替这些企业做了很多的专利全球布局的一些的规划，包括从研发，从这个诉讼，然后后来他把这个热忱转到教学，所以现在世新、台科大，然后在交大都有授课，那担任替我们这个创学界啊，还有企业界做了很多的这个整合，等一下跟我们分享很好的这个案例。最重要的是我们今天我非常的佩服，就是前辈说他们这么年纪这么大还比我们更用功，这次我们要好好的来跟他们做一个学习。我们的年轻的希望就是我们的林俊廷林博士，那他是来自我们的国家实验研究院，对，国家实验研究院，他等一下跟我们介绍一下台湾在标准必要专利上面做了哪一些的努力。
那final panel to present Korean experience on essential patentcultivation and globalization. Considering the time, we actually ran out of the time, so yeah, his presentation will be a very short one.
So, very good to see you join our session. I'd like to say a few words, maybe interact with you, because I don't like one-way street. I want to know what kind of questions you have after. So after 2 hours of standard essential patent, are you all experts in standard essential patents? So, does anybody in this room have a pattern of his own? Do you have pattern? Of course you do. Do you have patterns? You don't? Okay. So that's what I thought. Say, can you sell a pattern? Do you have a pattern? Can you sell it? Do you think? Can you sell it?
Yes.
Yes, you can sell it. Can you buy it?
Sure.
Do people sell and buy patterns? Yes, they do. Big money. Can you lease your pattern? Can you loan your pattern to somebody else? Yes, you can. Can you put pattern in a bank as a collateral and get cash from the bank? Can you do that? I don't think in Taiwan. Where can you do that? This concept is called IP financing, intellectual property financing. This is very advanced, developed. Where is it? All this is possible. This is everything I said is possible. Where? What country? Of course, what country? The most financed, developed country in the world. America. Everything's possible. They have very sophisticated financing technology combined with IP. You can do almost everything. We say that's the most advanced stage in the world. In Asia, Japan is next stage, close to the United States. And then there's Korea, and then Singapore, Hong Kong, trying to catch up with the trend of the world. I don't know where Taiwan is, to be honest with you. Maybe I'll have a better idea next time I meet with you. So I'm going to stop there. ask you to ask questions. If not, we go to dinner together. Any questions, fine. Why do we need standard essential patterns? Any questions, fine. Professor Chen?
In Korea, how do you evaluate the price of a patent? What tool you use? Evaluation system.
So if you want to put your patent as collateral, if you want to buy, if you want to sell, you need to evaluate, right? You need to evaluate your patents. Professor Chen is right. How do you do that? Do you think there should be a formula for that? Do you think that there is one consensus formula in the world to exactly put a price on a patent? Do you think so? I don't think so. This is exactly like real estate. Okay, piece of real estate. Why do I say that? You have a patent. You have mobile phone patent, for example. Maybe it's $100,000, US dollars. But then again, maybe Apple comes along, wants to buy it. What happens to the price? You say $100,000 and Apple comes and wants to buy it. Stay at 100K? At least $1 million, right? This is exactly like real estate. Like when you sell a building, somebody, some big company shows up at your door, wants to buy your building, what happens to the price? This is exactly like, this is the difficulty of evaluating patterns. This is like a science. This is like art. There is no one answer right now. Standard essential patterns, on the other hand, is very easy to evaluate because it's all well formulated in terms of its price and value. It's an exception.
So there is no standard method in Korea.
Pardon me?
I mean, evaluation of patent, you don't have a standard method.
So when is a patent really evaluated? The patent is really evaluated by a court, by the judge. Because somebody said there's patent litigation, right? Somebody is using your right, so you want to prevent him. Did you know every court in the United States has different method? And every organization in Korea has different method. In Korea, even in Korea. How about Taiwan? Same? Similar?
Yeah, I
think so. Yeah, this is a big headache, but very practical problem, very interesting problem. So, I think if you solve this, you'll win the Nobel Prize in IP.